Hello, malty Machiavellian meanderers, and thank you to NeanBlack666 for that malt mention introducing, as it does, Whisky Review 308. Now, before I launch back into some Scotch whisky reviews after a wee run of New World, World whiskies and Japanese whisky reviews, I thought I'd just take this opportunity to introduce you to various ways of marking and identifying bottles. Now, for all you whisky collectors out there, you may find this of particular interest. For all you distillers out there who like to be hands-on in promoting your whisky, you brand ambassadors, when people come to you and ask you to sign bottles and all that stuff, well, it's time for an update. In fact, for any whisky drinker that wants to kind of personalise the outside of the bottle a little bit, put a bit more of a legend on, enhance the story that surrounds a special bottle of whiskey, well, I'm going to show you basically a personal perspective on the options. Now, the first option is the good old permanent marker, which distillers use. Forget ballpoint pens. You do see bottles of whiskey at auction where someone has scribbled with a ballpoint pen, a message or a signature onto a label. The problem is that if you go to register a birth, marriage or death, right, at your local authority's office, they will not hand you a standard biro pen. For a very simple reason, when you sign official documents, when you sign some legal documents, they have to be permanent ink, and it's surprising that over 20, 30 years, even away from sunlight, the quality of ink in your standard pen is such that signatures simply fade away. And that is why when you're registering formal documents at your lawyer's office, or whether it's birth, marriage or death certificates at a registry, they give you the fountain pen with the Indian ink, because the ink that's marked onto the paper from these type of pens lasts hundreds of years. So we can put away the biro pen. It's not much good. The next option is the permanent felt tip marker. Now, it's all very, let's see. All very bold, it's all very visible. It works a treat. You can even mark the glass itself as well as the label of the bottle with a permanent marker. The problem is that the permanent marker is permanent in the short term, but rather a lot of permanent markers, unless they are produced specifically for permanent marking, which would be the case in some scientific laboratories, etc. The sun, any daylight, quickly bleaches out the colour, so that they may last for a few years, but again, over time they will fade. And when you've had your bottle of whiskey signed by a master distiller in the distillery, and you're thinking, oh my goodness, this has increased the value of this bottle, as soon as the signature starts to fade, it is harder to authenticate and to confirm as genuine. So again, you've got the problem, the permanent marker, it isn't 100% permanent, in fact far from it. So the latest thing that the distillers have been using, and whiskey fans as well, is the plastic paint pen. Now, plastic paint is, rather than ink, you have a reservoir which contains, I'll make a wee mark in the bottle and show you, that's the best way of explaining it. These are particularly good for signing on the glass of bottles rather than on labels, although you can sign in labels. And this tends to be increasingly used within the whisky industry by the master blenders, brand ambassadors, or stars, malt stars, that they want to kind of personalise your bottle for you. And they're quite useful, but they've got a problem with these. And I only discovered this actually when I was talking to a scientist friend who had been marking her bottles with this kind of pen, because she felt it was, there was physical paint going onto the bottles, therefore it was more permanent and it would last longer. And it also wouldn't be subject to smudging the way some markers on glass can do. But what she found that was over time, particularly in strong sunlight, the plastic paint eventually crumbles and powders and comes off. And this is where my Merry Maltsters, I introduce a device which will permanently mark a bottle like no other marker can. Here it is. You can buy it on eBay. It's not expensive. This is a silver line glass engraver. It's a very thick pen, but you can carry it around in your pocket. It's quite transportable. I don't know if they'd let you on an aeroplane with it, but you could always try. They're not expensive. And basically you've got a little motor in the head, a couple of batteries and a little button, and importantly at the tip you have got a drill. And what the drill does, I will demonstrate here. Is it permanently scratches the side of the glass. Now, it's a fairly superficial scratch, but it clearly marks the bottle, and it's fairly shallow, so it's not going to damage the ability of the bottle to keep its strength. You don't have to worry about weakening the strength of the bottle by using this. But I think it's a great idea. Here's one I did earlier. Whisky Review 308, ralphie.com. There we are. I'll hold this forward so as you can see it. There we are. Just a little drill. And once you mark the bottle, that's it. It's permanent. It can't be rubbed off. It won't fade in the light. It won't flake and crumble over time. This sort of inscription in the bottle will last quite simply as long as the bottle lasts, which could be hundreds of years. As far as I'm concerned, this is probably the most useful engraver for the whisky fan for marking bottles. Let me see, what else can you do? If you are a whisky collector and you're selling on your own bottles and you want people to have an idea whether your bottles are fake or not, if you're a big whisky collector and someone has bought a bottle from you and then sells on that bottle and someone says, hang about, it's a fake and you owned it, bit of an embarrassing moment. You can use these engravers to put little light indelible marks on the bottle at various points, which will help authenticate whether the bottle that they're claiming used to belong to you is yours. Even the plastic, by the way. You can mark plastic and metal. Great idea. Another good idea for you collectors, if you want a situation where bottles in your collection can be secretly marked, so not literally, you could engrave a wee mark, engrave underneath the bottle or anywhere around using the silver line engraver, but you could also consider using invisible ink. Now here's an invisible ink pen. This is used for marking banknotes, and It's quite common, certainly in the UK, that large denomination banknotes are held under a ultraviolet lamp to confirm their authenticity and that they're not fakes. And you can do the same with a bottle of whiskey. All you need is it doesn't cost a lot. This is a UV torch. I call it a warehouse torch, actually, because you get a standard light, you get a laser light, right? So as you can point out casks that are right at the back of the warehouse, which you've got no chance of reaching, but you can see that cask over there. I'd like to buy that, and I'm going to offer you double the money, etc., etc. I mean, some people do that. Not me. But onto the UV light. There we go. And you can see I've marked the front of this bottle with a nice happy sunshine face that would not be immediately obvious on first glance. So you can use these, even you get invisible markers for glass, so that when you have a whiskey collection, you can mark up with your own secret mark on your bottles. And if you happen to sell them and someone comes back to you and says, "I bought a bottle and it used to belong to you, and I don't think it's genuine," you can confirm whether the bottle is genuine or not simply by locating your own mark. Or alternatively, if your collection is stolen, and that does happen, there is actually evidence that some fairly substantial whiskey collections have been stolen over the years, and that trend will continue with the increasing market value of some whiskies. So a word to all you whiskey collectors: don't flaunt your collections too wide and far. Don't keep your collections all in the one place. What I do, so I've got my collection split 5 different locations. It's just partly my own paranoia. But also, it saves me the temptation of digging into too many good whiskies at the one time. Yeah, it's another consideration. But that is basically it. When using this, practice on an empty bottle. You will find initially that your hand tends to slide when you're using it. Practice makes perfect, and if you're taking one of these devices, a little mini engraver, bottle engraver, along to a distillery and expecting the master distiller or brand ambassador or malt star to sign the bottle for you, it's a good idea to let them practice on an empty bottle first before they put their signature onto your collectible bottle. Otherwise, the signature's going to be all over the place. Finally, time capsule yourself a bottle. What you do is you buy a bottle of whiskey today. A bottle of whiskey is not too expensive, and you know it's going to be good quality, but you're not going to touch it until 20 years or 30 years down the line, depending on what age you are at the moment. And what you do is engrave yourself a message. Put the date on the bottle and engrave yourself a message on the bottle, and then put it away. And when you bring that bottle out to open it and enjoy it with friends in good company in years to come, you can look back at the historical message, the time capsule message that you have sent yourself. There we go. Okie dokie. There's variations on the theme, by the way. I know of one chap who has bought an old bar mirror of blended whiskey, and he kind of carries it around with him. It's just a small mirror, and he gets one of these, and people engrave their signature in the mirror, and that's the way he kind of keeps it, like an autograph book. But I hope you found this a little bit different. I hope you found this an entertaining and useful vlog. Not all vlogs about whiskey, not 100% of the time. There is nothing worse than basing all your whiskey knowledge purely on other people's tasting notes about a certain whisky. I'm going to come back to this in the future in an advanced masterclass when I discuss how people's sense of smell and taste differ more than we realise, and how tasting notes can actually become a distraction to your ability to just relax and enjoy a whisky experience. I hope you'll join me again. Whisky Review 309. We'll be back to whiskies. I'm going to review some Scotch whisky. Probably a single malt. Probably a reasonable price. Reasonable presentation. And, of course, Ralphie recommended. Join me again when I return. whiskyreviews@ralphie.com. Wonderful. Best hobby I've ever had.